Buonasera, benvenuti alla casa di Marco. Welcome a Marco's place. Tonight we are gonna make risotto. Risotto with mushrooms. I found beautiful mushrooms at the Monterey market. I have the parsley, Italian parsley, 70 grams of rice, two fists. If you don't have grams, you go buy fists. This is onion, specifically this one is the shallot, okay? But onion is the same. I have butter. Then I'm gonna use parmigiano and the broth. I'm gonna put some butter in the pan, like this. And I'm gonna start a little bit the heating, slowly, okay? Stir fry 250 Fahrenheit. In the meantime, I'm gonna cut the shallot. I'm gonna cut the shallot. Here it is. The risotto is typical from Northern Italy. It's a dish typical from Northern Italy because in the Po Valley, between Milano and Torino, we have fields and production of rice. So it is typical from North, and this kind of risotto is typical on fall. When summer is ending, we start doing a risotto with mushrooms or risotto with zucca, riso di zucca. Zucca is the I don't remember zucca. It's easy, man. Zucca. It's easy. Oh yes. Zucca. Pumpkin, man. It's typical from fall. All right. So let's put the shallot here. I'm gonna show you a little bit of olive oil, just a drop of olive oil. Okay, I don't need the butter for now. Then I'm gonna cut some of the parsley to give flavor. Okay? You see, I'm adding just the hard part of the parsley. In the meantime, as you can see, I'm gonna show you. Let me show you. You see that the broth is boiling. I put one onion, parsley, onion, carrot, and the celery, okay? Onion, one onion, one carrot, and two pieces of celery. Now I'm gonna add the riso, the rice. I'm gonna add the rice, and it should become, the rice should become golden color, okay? We are toasting. Roasting, a kind of roasting, but not heavily, slowly. There is a movie which is called Riso Amaro, bitter rice, or also bitter laughter, bitter laughter. So the rice, as you can see, is becoming golden color. I'm gonna add a little bit of wine. A little bit of wine, and I leave it increasing to evaporate. A little bit of broth. In order to avoid
di Monterey Market. Beautiful mushrooms.
Obviously, the mushrooms, it depends from the taste of the mushrooms.
Normally, I used to use the porcini, but now this is what we have. I could not find porcini. And the risotto has
to be always boiling, covered.
This is for after, and this one I'm gonna put now.
I was telling you that Riso Amaro was a famous movie of the Italian cinema after Second World War. We had a style which was called neorealism. And there were famous movies like Roma Città Aperta, Riso Amaro, Ladri di Biciclette, and many others. It was really a great, at that time, De Sica, Gassman, lots of great actors and directors. And this movie was about Silvana Mangano. She was a beautiful lady, and she was a worker in the rice fields, and she met a guy whose name was Marco, and Marco was trying to be in love with her, but he didn't succeed. Man, never, he didn't succeed with Silvana Mangano. And then it is kind of a melodramatic story, because the end is not nice. This is to tell you that we have in the Po Valley production of rice, very good rice, northern Italy, and that is why the risotto is a typical dish. It's a typical dish of the northern Italy. But then, obviously, also in the southern part, we normally add the fish, and we do risotto alla pescatora, for instance, with shrimps, gamberi, mussels, cozze, clams, vongole, what else? Calamari, okay, squid. We do risotto alla pescatora. Maybe one day we are gonna make it. This one is with mushrooms, and risotto should cook some 20 minutes. Okay, let me try the rice and see if it's ready. After 20 minutes, slow cooking, 20 minutes, 300 Fahrenheit. Let me try the grains. Should be homogeneously cooked, okay? It's good. Now I'm switching off, adding. Now andiamo a mantecare il riso, whisk, with some butter and some parmigiano cheese. Parmigiano cheese. Mantechiamo il risotto. I wanna put also, you know what, some black pepper, which I think goes well. So pepper, okay, black pepper, a little bit of butter and parmigiano cheese. I'm gonna switch on again a little bit, just to absorb a little bit of liquid, more of this liquid. Okay, whisking. Mantecare si dice whisk in English. I didn't know that. Okay, now I'm switching off. Last time switching off. Then we're gonna take some of the risotto.
Oh. Oh. Guys, this is the second dish of risotto that I'm having, and the second one looks more relaxed. In fact, risotto often is better if you leave 5 minutes after the cooking to relax, to cool down a little bit, and you will get the real taste of the risotto. It's really, really good. Trust me. Arrivederci dalla casa di Marco. Ciao.